Hello? Hi, is this Baba Brinkman?
Yeah, who's this?
Baba Brinkman, the rapping evolutionist?
Yeah.
I'm not sure how to tell you this, but it's a bit awkward, but I'm your identical twin.
Oh shit.
Yeah, I tracked you down with the Google search. I've known for about 2 years, but I thought, nah, it's just too weird.
What? No way. When's your birthday?
Oh, it's October 22nd, 1978. Same as yours. I tracked you through an adoption agent. I've been watching you since about 2008. I can't say why our biological parents would want to separate us, but anyway, I thought we should, you know, get acquainted.
Sorry, I don't know what to say. I'm shocked. I can't wait to talk to my mom and dad and just ask them what the hell they were on, giving up an identical twin for adoption. But I guess they probably had their reasons.
So I guess that means you're a pretty easygoing guy, huh? Because I thought you might, you know, be angry or maybe even cry.
Well, maybe when I see you I might need to dry an eye, but for now I'm just completely surprised and curious as hell. I mean, what's the deal? What do you do? Do you have kids? Do you take care of yourself? Are you married? I mean, this is very surreal. Have you ever read about twin studies? It's like the only way we can tell which elements of the personalities we develop can be called the result of the environmental field compared to the part that's been genetically built.
Yeah, I'm not so into science, but my job is that I teach creative writing at a community college, and yeah, I have a little girl and a beautiful wife. We've been married since 2005.
Creative writing. When you were a kid, did your adopted parents read to you at night?
I know, they weren't really book people. Why?
It's just that my dad always likes to take credit for my success as a rapper because he read to me as an infant. But I always wondered whether my language instincts were genetic, and this is evidence.
I really picture this reunion as having a bit more emotional resonance.
Yeah, well, you're not exactly pouring on the expressiveness yourself.
I know. I've never seen the necessity. My wife tells me it's an emotional repression thing, but I'm not unaffectionate. It just seems excessive to me.
Yeah, that could be a description of me.
Okay, well, if we're questioning, what about you? Wife? Girlfriend?
Nah, I'm not really a relationship type of person. I mean, it's not like an aversion. It's just that I'm always on tour, and it's tough to imagine how to even try to work it in.
But rapping, you must get some attention from women.
Attention, sure, but I'm not indiscriminate. I mostly tour college campuses. You can picture it, in town for one night. Most women just aren't into it. I mean, there's been an occasional grad student incident.
My wife is a grad student.
Yeah, well, I'm envious. I wish I could have that kind of connection. Intimate. My lifestyle could hardly be more itinerant.
You came to my college in 2006, rapped the Canterbury Tales for the medieval English class.
What? Why didn't you contact me?
Because I didn't know. I only tracked you down 2 years ago, remember? Plus, I was on sabbatical. Me and my wife, we had this whole... That time was stressful.
Oh, sorry, bro.
Look, it's not your fault. It's just that I turned into this guy, this safe provider type, and I panicked, and I left my wife, and I moved to the other side of the planet, to Europe, but it just didn't fit me. I was just an anonymous writer in a big city, and I wasn't confident with women, so I lasted 6 weeks.
And your wife took you back, huh?
Yeah, I guess that's love. And then 9 months later, along came little Rebecca.
9 months later?
Yeah, give or take. It's funny how our lives are developed in different ways. I mean, I envy your lifestyle. It looks pretty flat out. I decided to contact you when I saw you on Rachel Maddow.
Yeah, she's fantastic. So you and your wife, you've been happy since your little European crisis?
Yeah, she's a good mother. I'm lucky to have her.
And you're never tempted to, you know, stray from the pasture? Hook up with one of your students, maybe? I don't know, do something crazy?
Yeah, I'm tempted, occasionally, but it's a two-way street, right? I mean, basically, how can I trust her if she can't trust me?
And you trust her?
Yes, now, but I've had some jealous times. I mean, when Rebecca was, like, 2 and a half, I took her to the clinic, and I got a checkup, and I asked the doctor to give her a paternity test on the side.
Really, why? Does she have, like, an ethnic vibe?
Nah, she looks like me. She's freckled and white. She was just born a bit quickly after that difficult time, and I didn't want to be suspicious, but I...
And the verdict?
The doctor said she's definitely mine, 100% DNA test certified.
Ah, that's great then. I'd love to meet your kid.
And my wife.
Yeah, I was gonna say that next. Okay, look, I have to go. There's this thing for the Fringe. I'm writing this play about...
Yeah, human nature, yes. I've been tracking you through your Facebook friends. I'll be interested to hear what you have to say about twins.
Yeah, well, as soon as I can, I'll come visit you.
Okay, Baba, just call me when you're ready to.
We'll be right back. We'll be right back.